Morning, this is Calvin Russell, CEO and founder of 850 Club Credit Consultation. Hope everyone's doing well today. Today, we're going to talk about the top 10 banks that if you are financed with these banks right now, if you have your auto loan with them right now, we need to refinance, we need to trade in, or we need to throw the whole car. No, I'm kidding. So, but you either got to refinance as soon as you can, or you need to trade in as soon as you can to get the hell out of that high interest rate, all right? Now, not all the time do they give you a higher interest rate. What's high interest rate? Everybody's different. Some of you all have never paid double-digit interest rates for an auto loan. Some of you all have never paid single digits. So because of that, these type of lenders, they are, I won't say shady, because let's be totally honest, a lot of times we get denied and they're the only bank to say yes, and we really needed that car and we were not in a position to pay cash for it. That doesn't mean that things are all horrible. It just takes a little bit of stuff, a little bit of work to get out of it. All right. So if you didn't see my video the other day on how Santander is now in trouble, some of these banks may end up in the same boat, and it's coming soon. So the number one bank that you need to get the, like, run out of that situation is Santander. You already know it. I did the video on it the other day. Now, when I used to sell cars, man, listen, there were all the banks would say no. They would say no, denied, but Santander found a way to say yes, right? Not all the time, but I would say if Santander said no, you were horrible, okay? So, and then that's the thing. We don't want people to feel bad, but just listen, we have to, I almost say a man, Joe, that's a Chicago thing. But either way, you have to understand that you have to pay somebody on time. As adults, we gotta pay somebody on time. Somebody, anybody, right? And you have to understand that our options are slim. Options become really slim the lower the list of people. I mean, the longer the list, I should say, of people that you haven't paid on time. And that leads to banks like this. But number one is going to be Santander. You already know why. High interest rates. And when you're late, oh my God, I don't even know. What they were doing was completely illegal. And of course, states have figured it out. It's so many issues that go on. A lot of stuff gets swept under the rug. And but you get banks like this, they're doing 10,000 deals a month. You know, so who can keep up with that, right? And you're hoping these dealerships are on top of it. They're not on top of it. I worked at a dealership for 6 years. There were plenty of times where, you know, well, Santander, they always ask for income and stuff like that. But the problem is Santander should have said no, and they said yes. So that's Santander. But again, if you haven't watched that video, if you had a repossession between 2010 and 2019, not only are they clearing the balance, you know, on your credit report and in real life, but they're actually giving some people some checks just simply because of the fact that they did business with Santander. Now, if you've been with Santander for, let's say, about 3 or 4 years, and they and they've been looking for your car since December of 2019, that the state is actually forcing Santander to give you the title to your car without having to pay anything else. That's going to take some time. Wait on it. So that's the number one bank. Number two bank, Regional Acceptance. Okay, that's number nine. Regional Acceptance, high interest rates, can't get out the loan. All right, again, find a way to get out of these loans. Credit Acceptance. Now, I'm actually a big fan of Credit Acceptance because they really helped a lot of people. But is Credit Acceptance really simple? How, you know, if you had a cash income, if you had multiple repossessions, if you had a repossession yesterday. Well, actually, if you had a repossession yesterday, you can go with any bank you want. Depends on what the balance is on the credit report. But usually, Credit Acceptance is the best bank to go with if you just had a repossession like the other day, because they don't question certain things. I'll give you a great example. There's a lady who was a 720 credit score. Credit was fine, right? But she put the car in her daughter's name. 100%. I'm sorry. The daughter wanted a car. The daughter's credit wasn't the best. And when the mom co-signed, the number still sucked. So the mom says, all right, I'll put the whole car in my name. Now, when mom wants to go get a car, guess what? It's difficult now because mom makes about $30,000, $40,000 a year. Why do I bring up income? Because we need about $75,000, $80,000 a year for the banks to say, okay, depending on the car payment too, but about $400 payments for two cars, $400 and $400, $350 and $350, $450 and $450, something like that. Banks are okay with that. Most lenders are okay with that. Since this was the case, she didn't make that money to do so. So it's like, hey, you either got to trade this car in, which you got to tell your daughter, hey, listen, you got to trade your car in so mom can have a car, right? She didn't want to do that. That's where credit acceptance came in. So there are some good things about it. But again, don't forget the basic. The basic part about it is high interest. Get out of that high interest as soon as possible. All right. Now, these are just popular high interest rate banks that you probably like, man, I didn't even know they had that. Yeah, they everywhere. Okay. Credit acceptance. Next one, Westlake Financial. I don't have to say much because this ain't even the worst. Like, there's one on here that's super close to Santander, but Westlake, they're not too far either, okay? Westlake, again, high interest rates, and they are booming. They're going to be the third Santander. You watch and see. They're going to be the third because they're running up a lot of numbers. They're building a lot of relationships. They're in different countries right now. It's going crazy right now with Westlake Financial, but get out of that loan as soon as possible. Friendly Finance. They are not friendly at all. I don't even know if they're still in business anymore, but people were stuck in those loans, high interest rates, couldn't get out of them. They put people in 10-year-old cars. They say, listen, if it start, we'll give you a loan for it. Run up out of that situation, all right? Honor Finance, they were never honorable. I'm just coming up with all this random stuff. So either way, but no, Honor Finance. Some of you guys are like, man, I had a loan with them, man, back in the day. Listen, get out of that loan as soon as possible, all right? Exeter, all right? Now, Exeter, if I believe it or not, they're actually based out of New Orleans, I believe. If not them, there was another one. I can't remember, but there was another. It was Exeter, and there was another one that wasn't too far from that one. But either way, again, Exeter, get out of that situation as soon as possible. Now, road loans, look in. Now, road loans, you probably got some stuff in the mail. Road loans was real heavy on mailers and things of that sort, trying to say, hey, we can do business with you, yada, yada, blah. Listen, I'm telling you, road loans, again, just to run away from it. The deals never work out. You got to put all, they send you the mailer, but the car has to meet so many parameters. Then the dealership has to kind of squeeze the parameters in, and it only works if they own the car, if they have a certain amount of profit on the car, you know, so every car won't work. So, you know, it's just, it was too much. And then again, when you finally did, the loan did finally go through, the interest rate was stupid high in this, excuse me, and you just got to get up out of that loan as soon as possible. Because again, what they did was it was like a bait and switch. The bait gets you in, you get there, they switch all the things around. They say, oh yeah, you can get this interest rate. They know good and well you don't qualify. You know you don't qualify. And you take that into the dealership, and then things don't work themselves out. So you most definitely want to make sure you don't fall for it, get out of that situation. But the number two bank that's just as worse as Santander, J.D. Byrider. Now, if they don't have it in your bank, if they don't have it where you're at, if you've never had a loan, you ain't missing nothing. You're not missing nothing with J.D. Byrider, okay? Also, now, if they've changed who they've done their financing name as. Now it's under CNAC, okay? So run from them. Run. Do not know. Listen, I don't care how bad your credit is. It doesn't take long to get your score up just a little bit, high enough, to where you'll get slightly better terms from banks who are actually being looked at all the time, right? Well, you can get a loan with Ally Financial, and if Ally doesn't work, then it'll work with GM Financial. It'll work with other banks that are out there, Capital One, AmeriCredit. So there's some other options out there that are not flat out horrible. But if you finance with any of those banks, it's time to refinance or trade in. Well, Calvin, I'm upside down. Save that money and get run out of that loan because you're in a spending so much money. Now, you're probably saying, well, Calvin, I'm with Santander right now. Does the whole situation help me? Not if you just got with them. I will say if you've had a loan with them, and I will say probably between now and 2 years ago, I don't think it's really going to help you because you're right in the middle of it. And that doesn't mean that you should start defaulting on your loan just so you can kind of wait. Listen, if it took them 5 years to get Santander to get to this point, there's no telling how long it's going to take in general, okay? So I just want you to kind of keep that in mind. Man, this COVID is really, like, it's so hard for me to I gotta get my hair cut, all this stuff. I got, oh, this stuff is just growing. I can just feel it. I can cut this part. I can't cut this. Anyway, enough of the sidebars on that. Anyway, so if you have loans with any of these people, get out of these loans as soon as you can, ASAP, refinance, trade in the car, save your money, do something, okay? Now, I'm not going to tell you to do something illegal like burn it or something like that. Don't do that, okay? So you're like, man, I never thought about that. Don't do that. Please don't, all right? If you like this video, like it, want to share it, share it, and as always, be sure to subscribe as we have nothing but the great content that you've already been seeing on the way. Thank you all so much. See you on the next video.